Muy buenos días, ya estamos aquí en la Miranda School TV. Mi nombre es James, James Reporter, y hoy es jueves, jueves día 18. Y esta tarde tenemos una cita a las 6 de la tarde con nuestro concierto de extraescolares. Pero antes no queríamos dejar la mañana sin seguir aprendiendo. Vamos a empezar la mañana con Miss Conchi, quien nos va a hablar sobre unos beats de las flores. Continuaremos con parte del proyecto de los chicos y chicas de P5 que nos hablan sobre África y animales africanos. Esta vez nos toca conocer a los lémures. Sí, sí, unos animales muy interesantes. Continuaremos con un poquito de mindfulness de la mano de la profesora Ana Carolina para dar paso a Mr. Ignasi, quien pondrá ritmo a nuestra mañana. Ay, tengo algo que contaros, chicos. Pero no sé cómo hacerlo. Mañana es viernes, día 19, último día de cole. Ay, estoy un poquito triste, pero no pasa nada. Ja, nos veremos el año que viene, ¿sabes? Y además, mañana viernes tenemos un programa especial para vosotros. Sí, sí, un programa especial. Nuestro Got Talent en directo. Ja, no te lo pierdas. Dentro vídeo.
Bits de les flors. Tulipa. Hortènsia. Lliri. Clavell. Margarites. Rosa. Rosella. Girassol. Lavanda. Orquídia.
Let's learn all about lemurs. Lemurs are mammals. They belong in the same family as apes, like gorillas and monkeys. They have long, bushy tails and big yellow eyes, although sometimes they have blue eyes. Sometimes you'll see lemurs on two legs and sometimes on all fours. You'll find lemurs on the African island of Madagascar. They like to live in forests like rainforests or grasslands. Lemurs are considered the most endangered group of animals in the world. There are over 100 different kinds of lemur. The biggest lemur in the world is called the Indra lemur, and the smallest is this mouse lemur. Lemurs are very sociable. That means that they like to have a lot of friends. They live in groups called troops. Lemurs, like gorillas, only have one baby at a time. The baby lemur is called a pup. Most lemurs like to spend their day in the trees or sunbathing. When they're not sunbathing though, they're looking for food. Lemurs are herbivores. That means that they don't eat meat. They like to eat fruits, leaves, flowers, and nectar. Lemurs are considered to be the most endangered animal in the world. Because in Madagascar, where they live, they're cutting down the trees of the forest. Luckily, there's a lot of people that want to help the lemurs, and there's a lot of wildlife and national parks to protect them. Have you seen the movie Madagascar, where the lemurs like to move it, move it? Well, actually, it's true. Lemurs are great dancers. And they like to move it, move it.
I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. Yeah, I like to move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. Yeah, I like to move it. I like to move it. You like to move it, move it. She like to move it, move it. He like to
move it.
All girls all over the world. original King Julian. What a case, man. I love her. Woman, physically fit. Physically fit. Physically, physically, physically fit. Woman, physically fit. It. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. You like to
move it.
I like to move it, move it. You like to move it, move it. She like to move it, move it. He like to
move it.
All girls all over the world.
Hello, how are you? Okay, so today we're going to practice mindful eating, and that is paying attention to what we are eating at the moment. So for this exercise, I would like you to get a piece of fruit or chocolate that you have in your house. So go get it really quick. You can pause the video, and when you have the fruit or the chocolate, we're going to practice mindful eating. So here I have a tangerine or mandarina. So what we're going to do is we're going to pay attention to this piece of fruit that you have in your hand. It can be a banana, it can be a tangerine. Any fruit you have around the house would be great. So this exercise you can practice by yourself, but it would be awesome if you invite your mom, your dad, your sister, your brother, or anybody you have in your family to practice this exercise because it's really fun. So you're going to take the piece of fruit and first we're going to look at it, okay? As if it was the first time we see this piece of fruit, okay? Try to detail it, see the color, see if it has something different that you have never seen before. So just pay attention to this piece of fruit or chocolate that you have in your hand, okay? Look at it really detailed. For example, this tangerine that I have here, it's really like orange and it has like all these white things around it, so it's really cool. So a lot of times we eat and we eat very fast and we don't pay attention to what we are eating. So now that we have a lot of time at home, we can eat very slowly and practice mindful eating. Okay, so after you take a look at this fruit that you have in your hand or this chocolate, we're going to smell it, okay? Just try to see how it smells. Maybe you can close your eyes to help you smell better. So see how it smells, if it smells sweet or maybe sour. Mm-hmm. So this tangerine smells sweet and it's a little cold too because I had it in the freezer. So it's really, it smells really sweet. So now you're gonna touch it. Okay, so we're going to touch the fruit, try to see the texture maybe, okay, the fruit or whatever you have in your hand right now. Okay, and now we're going to listen to the food you have in your hand. And you're going to say like, oh, this is weird. My food doesn't sound anything, okay? It doesn't make any sounds, but it does. If you put it in your ear, you can little maybe squish it a little bit, and try to touch it to see if you can see any sounds that come up. Okay. Very good. Try to see if you can listen something. Okay. And now we are going to eat it. But how are we going to eat it? Fast or very slow? We're going to eat it very, very slow, paying attention to the flavors in our mouth, okay? So don't swallow it right away. Just try to put it in your mouth and savor your fruit or your chocolate, okay? So I'm gonna do this with my little tangerine. Mm-hmm. I took a little bite. You can close your eyes and just let it melt in your mouth. Okay, so my tangerine tastes really sweet and it's cold and it has like a little texture. So this is like I always tell you, mindfulness is an experiment. So we're doing experiencing our food, because if we eat slowly, we can experience our food, okay? So you can eat the rest of your fruit and really enjoy it, okay? Enjoy it, see the flavor, okay? Okay, perfect. So what you're going to try to do these days that you are in home, in your house, with your family, is try to pay more attention to the food you are eating, okay? Try to eat slower. For example, if you have for breakfast something that you love, if you have pancakes or eggs, right? You can eat it really slowly and savor it and pay attention. This helps us be more focused in our food and be more present. Remember, mindfulness helps us, and it's a practice to help us be in the present moment. That is the only moment that we have. So now that we have a lot of time to be at home, we can take our time to eat very slowly and really enjoy and be in the present moment while we eat. So don't forget to practice this with your family. You can show them this video if you want. And I am sure it's going to be amazing, because if you pay attention to what you're eating, you're going to start discovering like new flavors, new textures, and it's really awesome. So I hope you practice it, and maybe when we see each other again, you can tell me a little bit about how did that feel, if you liked it, and if it was fun. So I really hope you have fun doing mindful eating, and I hope to see you soon. Bye!
Look at me, look at me, by Rose Williamson. Cammy Chameleon lived in a tree and was very good at hiding. Cammy turned brown on a brown branch and green on a green leaf. It made it very easy to sneak up on delicious bugs. But Cammy didn't want to hide. She thought she was a very beautiful chameleon indeed, and she wanted all the other animals to look at her. She called out to the tree frogs, "Look at me, look at me!" But the tree frogs could not see a green chameleon on a green leaf. She called out to the lemurs, "Look at me, look at me!" But the lemurs could not see a brown chameleon on a brown branch. Cammy was very upset that no one could see her. She began to wonder what it would be like if she didn't always blend in. Cammy climbed down from her tree and concentrated very, very hard and turned red. "Look at me, look at me," she called to the tree frogs. "What a beautiful chameleon," they said. Cammy practiced changing colour all day. She was pink on a grey stone. She was black on yellow sand. She was purple on an orange flower, and orange on a purple flower. "Look at me, look at me," she called to the lemurs. "What a beautiful chameleon," said the lemurs. Cammy thought she was the most beautiful chameleon in the whole world. Soon, she began to feel hungry and went home to her tree. Cammy climbed onto her brown branch and waited for a delicious bug. She waited and waited, and she watched the other chameleons catching bugs on their sticky tongues, and her stomach started to rumble. She was very hungry. Then Cammy saw a group of bugs nearby. But before she could stick her tongue out, they saw her beautiful colours and flew away. "What a beautiful chameleon," they said to her. Suddenly, Cammy felt very silly. A colourful chameleon couldn't hide like a plain brown chameleon. Cammy knew that to catch bugs, she would need to blend in. So she concentrated very, very hard and changed colour so that she could blend in with her surroundings. Cammy had learned that it's not good to show off and was happy being a regular chameleon again. But sometimes, just every once in a while, Cammy concentrates very, very hard and turns into all the colours of the rainbow. Hi everyone, it's time to get arty! Today we're going to draw a lemur. For this activity, you'll need some paper, a pencil, some colours or some paint. Before we start, let's have a look at what a lemur looks like. It's got two big yellow eyes and a long, bushy black and white tail. Let's get started! We're going to start by drawing a semicircle in the middle of our paper. From here, we're going to start drawing two big ears. We're going to try and draw two pointy ovals like this. Lemurs are famous for their two yellow eyes. So we're going to draw two big circles right in the middle of our lemur's face. For our lemur's nose, we're going to draw a teardrop shape, like this, right between the eyes. Now we're going to define our lemur's head. Right in between the ears, we're going to draw an upside down triangle, from one ear down to the middle of the eyes and up again. When we've done that, it's time to fill in our lemur's eyes and nose. And now let's start drawing the lemur's body. From the middle of his head, we're going to draw a curved line all the way down to the bottom of our paper and another one on the other side, like this. Next to our curved line on the left, we're going to draw a curved line to the middle, and then we're going to leave a little gap. From there, after the gap, continue your line all the way to the bottom of our paper. From the gap, we're going to draw the lemur's hand. Draw a line across, going all the way across his body, and join it up with another line. Our lemur is going to be holding something to eat. Coming out of his hand, we're going to draw a circle. I think our lemur is going to be munching on a yummy nut. We're going to draw his other hand holding the nut. But we can't see it very much, so all we need to draw is a slither of a line on top of the circle and then another small curved line going from the bottom of the nut all the way to its body, like this. Lemurs are famous for their long, bushy, black and white tails. So coming out of the bottom of the paper, we're going to draw a curved line all the way up to its ear. And then we're going to continue our curved line from behind its ear, curve it around and follow it all the way down to the bottom of the paper. Now it's time to draw our stripes on his tail. All that's left now is drawing some details. We're going to draw some details on the lemur's ear. Just underneath the line of the ear, we're going to draw another line. And we'll finish off drawing a crescent for his mouth. Now it's time to color our lemur in. Remember, lemurs' tails are black and white, and their body is light gray or white as well. Ah, and don't forget his distinctive yellow eyes. Now it's time to color in your background. I've chosen blue. And to finish off, don't forget to write lemur.
This is an addition. It's an horizontal addition, and it's how we've been working so far. A number plus a number equals another number. 5 plus 2 equals 7. But this is not the only way we can represent an addition or a subtraction. A math problem can also be stacked. It means one number on top of the other one. It doesn't have an equal sign. It has a line instead. For example, 4 plus 4, 8. And the answer goes under the line. 5 plus 2, the line, and then the result, 7. And of course, it works the same way with the subtraction. 6 minus 2, the line, and the result, 4. Now, we're going to practice with some word problems. Let's start with the addition. Tim has 3 Legos. Tina has 8 Legos. How many Legos do they have all together? Let's write the problem both horizontal and vertical. 3 plus 8 equals... Now pause the video and find out the solution counting the blocks. Well done! 3 plus 8 equals 11. Now let's write the problem vertically. 3 plus 8, a number on top of the other one, the line, and the result. Sally bought 8 toy cars in the shop, and Tom bought 4 toy cars in the shop. How many toys do they have all together? First, let's represent it in the horizontal way. 8 plus 4 equals, and now pause the video and find out the solution. Well done, 8 plus 4 equals 12. Now let's do it vertically. 8 plus 4, the line, and the result, 12. Well done. Let's practice now with the subtraction. There are 4 astronauts floating in the space. 3 of those astronauts floated away. It means we have to subtract them. 4 minus 3. How many astronauts do we have left? 1. Let's do it vertically now. 4 minus 3. And the result under the line. 1. Oh look! The rainforest! How many animals can you see? 2 sloths, 2 frogs, and 2 jaguars. 6 animals, but 2 of them, 1 sloth and 1 frog, run away. This means we have to do a subtraction. 6 minus 2 equals, let's write it vertically as well, 6 minus 2 and the line for the result. How many animals do we have left? 6 minus 2 equals 4. and 6 minus 2 equals 4, 2 jaguars, 1 sloth, and 1 frog.
Hello guys, are you ready to dance?
Y hasta aquí el capítulo de hoy. Se despide James Reporter. Nos vemos mañana. Cuídate.